السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي I am here to begin a very new lesson from the textbook named Snapshot. The title of the lesson is Birth. It is there given on page number 65. One of the most and one of the easiest lesson for your post midterm exam. I would request all the students to have the textbook in your hand and open page number 65 so you can understand it well. If you have any query question, feel free to write in the comment box given below the video. Right? Before I begin to read the textbook, I would request all the students to have the textbook in your hand. And as it is always that, first I would like to begin any new lesson from summary or the introduction of the lesson. So before I commence this lesson, before I start reading this lesson, I would like to begin. I would like to tell you the summary of this lesson so you can understand well. So let me share with you the summary of this lesson. First, it is there given in the textbook also. In this excerpt means a part of a big book that is called excerpt. In this excerpt from the Citadel, right, Andrew Manson, there is one doctor who is known, whose name is Andrew Manson, right, Andrew Manson. Newly out of medical school, he has just got his medical degree, he has just recently passed his medical degree. He just began his medical practice as an assistant to Dr. Edward Page in the small Wales mining town of Blenheliech. So he's there practicing with Dr. Edward, and Dr. Andrew has just got degree, his medical degree, and he's a new doctor, and he's there practicing along with senior doctor in one town of Blenheliech. As he's returning from a disappointing evening with Christian, Dr. Andrew was very unhappy with his girlfriend whose name is Christine, and he was there coming back from his workplace, and he had met his girlfriend also, and he was very unhappy. The girl he loves, he is met by Joe Morgan. Joe and his wife, who have been married nearly 20 years, are expecting their first child. So now Dr. Andrew was coming home. And when he just reached his home, he saw one person who is a mining driller, whose name is Joe. He was there waiting outside his house, and he was waiting for the doctor, Andrew, because his wife is pregnant and she was going to give birth to a child. And they got married last 20 years and they didn't have any child. So it was the first child. And he was waiting for the doctor, and he... seeing doctor, he becomes so happy, right? And this is how the story begins. Let's see. But let me tell you the summary of this great lesson. I would request all the students to keep your pen ready to write down the words meaning, because this lesson will increase your vocabulary. It will help you. It will enrich you in vocabulary, as well as it will make you rich in terms of glossary, in terms of new words and all this. So let me share with you the summary. The story Birth is an excerpt from Citadel. It relates how medical fresher handle a child delivery case in a mysterious way and bring back life in seemingly dead born child. In doing so, he applies his medical textbook knowledge as well as intuition. This is the story that this doctor who is just got his medical degree and he's just practicing, right? He handled the inborn child, he handled the stillborn child, he handled the lifeless born child in a such a way, in a such a beautiful way that made a surprise. The story expressed the anxiety and excitement of the doctor Andrew Manson and his team. Let's begin the story in nutshell. In the beginning of the story, it is narrated how Andrew Manson, who had recently passed out from a medical school, was returning home after a disappointing evening with his girlfriend, Christian, he was very unhappy with his girlfriend, and he was coming back from his workplace at home. It was midnight, and it was time of night, and when he reached near his house, he was requested by Joe Morgan to attend his wife immediately. So there was one person whose name is Joe. He was waiting for the doctor Andrew. He was standing, he was pacing up and down, he was just running here and there, he was walking, and he was waiting eagerly for the doctor. When he reached, he called the doctor. He drew the attention of doctor, saying that his wife is pregnant and she was about to give birth to a child, and she requires medical attention, she requires his help as a doctor. She was expecting her first child. Andrew agreed to go despite late night. Dr. Andrew was very unhappy. He was very frustrated because he had already had a very frustrated meeting his girlfriend, and he was very tired, very exhausted. But still, being a doctor, it was his duty. He followed his ethics and he decided to go with Joe to attend his wife. At the patient's house, Andy saw that the lady was being attended to by a midwife. There was a one, she was being looked after by midwife as well as by mother of that lady, right? So there were two ladies who were already looking after that Joe wife. Her name was Mrs. Morgan. Was very serious, and she was very in critical condition. She was not feeling comfortable, and she was so much worried because she was expecting her child, and at the same time they didn't have child for 20 years. Grandmother and midwife and husband, who were also very desperate, who were also keen to have the child, right? Andrew examined the patient and could understand that it would take some time for the delivery to take place. Being a doctor, he understood that it would take time. It would take 1 or 2 or 3 hours, right? He understood. He took a break, and meanwhile, he decided to have a break. In this period, Andrew's mind started wavering in stray thoughts, and he started thinking about his girlfriend and all this. His mind started thinking. He started thinking about Benwell, who was foolishly devoted to a man who deceived him mainly. His mind started wondering about Caleb's married life, and he was thinking about his friend who were not successful at all in their married life. So his friend's name is Benwell. He was being deceived by his wife, so he started thinking about that. Then he thought of Edward Page, second friend he started thinking, who was married to the ill-natured Bodwin, was now living unhappily apart from his wife. Andrew thought all marriages were dismal failure. In the meantime, Andrew had to go back to attend to the patient. So he was there thinking when he got time, and he was there thinking deeply about his friends who were not at all successful, because one of his friends was being deceived by his wife. She had an extramarital relationship with someone else, and second is totally collapsed. He was not happy with his married life. So he was thinking whether he should get married or not, all this, and he was thinking about his girlfriend also, Christian, right? Now the subsequent section narrates how after an hour long hard struggle, a child was born towards the dawn. So he just went to see his patient, and after he had to do lots of struggle to look after the mother and to look after the child, and after doing lots of struggle, the child was born at the time of dawn. But the child was still born. It was a dead child. It was almost a dead child. Still, it was like a rigid, hard child. There was no life inside the child. So the doctor was very much worried, because this was the first child after the 20 years of marriage, and he already promised to husband, to mother, and to grandmother and everyone that he would look after the he would look after patient, he would look after the child also, not to worry. And doctor was very frustrated, because the child, there was no life inside the child. Child was not breathing, it was stillborn child, it was dead child. When Andrew gazed at the lifeless form, when Andrew gazed at the lifeless form, he shivered with the horror. He started shaking, he started shivering, that what he would answer to these people, right? Then he looked at the mother. She required immediate attention, and he was to decide to whom to attend, the child or the mother. Now Dr. Andrew was in dilemma. Why he was in dilemma? Because mother condition was also critical, and child was already born, stillborn child, lifeless child. So what to do? Whether to look after mother or to look after the child, because both were there in critical condition, and he was in dilemma. Andrew gave the child to the nurse and turned his attention to the mother, who was unconscious. She was unconscious after giving birth to a child. Gradually, her heart strengthened, and Andrew could now leave her to attend to the baby. Gradually, her heart strengthened, and Andrew could now leave her to attend to the baby. And Dr. Andrew decided to give an injection, because when he started checking her pulse, it was not that much going. Pulse was running very slowly, right? It was not normal. So he decided to give injection. He injected her, right? After giving injection, the rate of the pulse were in normal position. Then after the seeing the mother condition was very nice, she was comfortable, and he drew attention to the child. Andrew gave the child to the nurse and turned his attention to the mother, who was unconscious. Gradually, her heart strengthened, and Andrew could now leave her to attend to the baby. Andrew asked about the child. The midwife was thoroughly frightened. She was thoroughly frightened that what would happen. The child is not breathing. Child is not even crying. Taking it as a still child, she had dumped it beneath the bed among sock and newspaper. She had dumped it beneath the bed amongst the newspaper. She put the child under the bed in newspaper. Andrew pulled out the child. Andrew just pulled out the child. The child was perfectly formed. The child, the limbs of the child, the parts of the child were perfectly formed. There was no any deformity. There was no any kind of handicap, right? The child was completely formed. But what happened? But child was not breathing. And he could understand that it was a case of suffocation due to lack of oxygen and excess of carbon dioxide in the blood. And he started giving the necessary treatment. He didn't lose heart. The midwife again told him that it was a stillborn child, but Andrew did not heed. He continued with his treatment. Midwife was there, keep on shouting that it was stillborn child still, but Andrew did not pay attention towards her, and he started treating the child. How he treated the child, let's see. Towards the end of the story, a miracle happened. Right, he rubbed the child with a towel, crushed and relaxed the little chest with both his hands. Then he tried to infuse the breath into his limb body. The little chest gave a short heave. The child started turning around. It was no longer a stillborn. What did Andrew do? He tried his level best to revive the child, but the child was not breathing at all, right? He start breathing the child inside his mouth. He start infusing his breath. He tried his level, but the child was not breathing. So he just went back to the nostalgia, and he remember one case that he learned in with his senior doctor, right? And he tried to apply that theory. He tried to apply that practical over here. He told the nurse to bring hot water and cold water. So the hot water and cold water was brought, and he He put the child into the hot water and he put child for a while. It was not hot water, it was warm water. And he put child in the cold water. Then after he started rubbing the chest of the child. Once he started rubbing the chest child and he rubbed the child with his with a towel, piece of towel. And then after child started breathing. And seeing him breathing, Dr. Andrew was so happy, right? At last Andrew heaved a sigh of relief. He handed the child to the nurse. He told the entire story to Joe standing outside and walked down the street with some miners with sense of dissatisfaction that he could achieve something great. When he came out of the house, husband was there standing. He was just running here and there. He was just walking here and there. And he told the entire story that how he look after the child and mother. And Dr. Andrew started walking with those people, with minors, and he got relief and he realized, he felt sense, he realized that this had never happened. This was the first case and it was very intricate case, it was very complicated case, and he handled it so nicely, so effectively, and it would really change his life. He had never had such experience before. It was the first case that he handled it so effectively, and he got a relief and he became so happy while going home back. Inshallah, we'll begin reading from the very first line in the very next video. I would request all the students to watch this video, try to understand. If you have any query, contact me or you can write down in the comment box. Meanwhile, you have to understand the story before reading, because there are many medical words are used. Right? So you have to listen the story to understand the story. Allah Hafiz.